All right, for day six, this is our last lesson for this chapter. We're going to add one extra step to the proofs that we've been doing in class for the last couple of days. So just a quick reminder, there are only four ways that we know of to prove any triangle is congruent. We have side, 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 angle, side, angle, side, angle, and angle, angle, side. And then we also have the secret weapon, I guess, that we can use for right triangles only, and that's hypotenuse leg. Alright, so the step that we're going to add to our proofs is, once you prove that you have triangles that are congruent, so once you've done what we've been doing, then you can say that any of the corresponding parts are congruent. So, corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. What does that really mean? Well, if you know, if you've gone through and you've proven that you have two triangles that are exactly the same, then you can say that any of the parts are going to be congruent, or they're going to be the same. So again, basically, what we're doing is exactly what we've been doing, and then we're just going to add one extra step at the end. All right, so why is this important? Well, sometimes we're not just asked to prove that triangles are congruent, but we're asked to prove that some of the parts are congruent. When that happens, what you want to do is first prove that you have triangles that are congruent, just like we've been doing all chapter, and then once you've proven the triangles are congruent, you can just add one extra step and say that the parts are congruent. All right, so let's go ahead and actually do a proof. First proof that we're going to take a look at. On your calculator, you have the given information, what we want to prove, and then you have a picture. For this picture, there is a circle, and the circle is really only meant at this point to be a distraction. So take a look at what you're given and see where your triangles are. So for this problem, we're given that AC and GC are equal. So I'm going to find AC and GC, and I'm going to mark those parts congruent. The second thing that I'm told is that EC bisects AG. So again, bisects means to cut in half. So if EC cuts AG in half, that means that AE and GE are equal. And then I'm out of givens. I'm out of givens, and for all of my methods, I need three pieces of information. Side, 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 angle, side, angle, 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 side, and then we have hypotenuse leg, but there's nothing here that tells us we have right angles. Okay, so hypotenuse leg isn't going to work for this problem. All right, so we need a third piece of information. We said that our secret weapons are one of two things. Look for vertical angles, and look to see if the triangles share anything. Well, these triangles share side EC. So that's three sides that I can say are congruent. So for this one, I'm going to prove that those two triangles are congruent using side, side, side. But that's not what they want me to prove. In the end, they want me to say that angle CAE is congruent to angle CGE. So this angle right here is congruent to this angle right here. Okay, notice I didn't put arcs in them because that's not part of my given information. That's what I want to prove. So my plan is to first prove that I have congruent triangles using side, 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 and then I can say that the angles are congruent using corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Okay, so here's how we write this up. First thing that we're going to do, the first thing that we're going to do is put our givens in our proof. So we start off with the two things that we are given. AC is equal to GC and EC bisects AG. And then what we want to do is look to see what those givens tell us. So this given right here, EC bisects AG, told us that AE and GE were equal. So that's the next thing that I put in my proof, and my reason, the reason I knew that was true, is because they use the word bisects in the given information. So that's my reason. Next thing I know is that EC is equal to itself, and whenever you say something is equal to itself, that's the reflexive property. Now, at this point, in my proof, I have three pairs of sides that are equal. Once you have your three pieces of information, then you can say that the triangles are congruent using whatever method you chose. In this case, side, angle, side. Or sorry, side, side, side. So, we are taking a look at triangle AEC and triangle GEC, and we're saying that they are congruent using side, side, side. Now, once you've proven that the triangles are exactly the same, then you can say that any of the parts are exactly the same. So, if they want us to prove that CAE is congruent to CGE, that's the next thing that we can write down, and our reason is that corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent, or we can shorten it a little bit to CPCTC. Alright, our second proof. Again, this time we have some given information and we have stuff that we want to prove. So again, our two pieces of given information are that triangle CDE is isosceles and that G is the midpoint of CE. And again, we have two angles that we want to prove congruent. So for this one, if I find my two angles, CDG, that's that angle there, and EDG is that angle there. So that's what I want to prove. And what I notice is that those two angles are part of those two triangles. So what I'm going to try to do is prove that the triangles are congruent, and then I can say that any of the parts are congruent. All right, so my first given says that triangle CDE is isosceles. What that means is that I have two sides that are equal, and also two angles that are equal. So if CDE is isosceles, so this triangle is isosceles, then I have two sides that are equal. I also have two angles that are equal. Remember that the angles are across from the two sides. So the angle across from this side would be angle C, and the angle across from this side would be angle E. So those are two congruent angles. And then my second given says that G is the midpoint of CE. So if G is the midpoint of CE, CG is equal to EG. And now I have three pieces of information. For this problem, I'm going to be able to prove that the triangles are congruent using side, angle, side. Now, one other thing that I want to point out. Some of you probably looked and said right away that those two triangles share a side. So you could also have said that DG is equal to itself using reflexive property, and then prove the triangle is congruent using side, side, side. Okay, does not matter which way you do the proof. It's whatever you see based on what you're given. All right, so how do we write this up? Well, again, we start off with our given information. So CD is isosceles and G is the midpoint of CE. And then based on our givens, we can write down some things that we know are true. So again, isosceles tells us that two sides are equal. So I write down the two sides that are equal, and the reason I know that that's true is because of the word isosceles up in the given. I also know that I have two angles that are equal, angle C and angle E, and again, that's because of isosceles. I also know that CG is equal to EG because of the midpoint that I was given. And so at this point, if I just do a quick check, right here I have a pair of sides, here I have a pair of angles, and here I have another pair of sides. So, at this point, I can say that those two triangles are congruent using side, angle, side, but that's not what they want me to prove. They want me to prove that those two angles, again, here and here, are congruent. So once we've said that the triangles are exactly the same, then we can say that any of the parts are exactly the same. So we can finish the proof by saying that the parts are congruent, so angle CDG is equal to angle EDG, that's exactly what they wanted us to prove, and our reason again is corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent, or shortcut CPCTC. All right, that is it for today.